नमस्कार, गुड मॉर्निंग डियर फ्रेंड्स. आई एम डॉक्टर विवेक विज. आई एम चेयरमैन एंड डायरेक्टर फॉर लिवर ट्रांसप्लांट एंड हेपेटोबिलरी सर्विसेज एट फोर्टिस ग्रुप ऑफ हॉस्पिटल्स. द पर्पस ऑफ मेकिंग दिस वीडियो टुडे इज टू एजुकेट योर सेल्फ एंड योर लव्ड वंस टू हाउ टू प्रोटेक्ट योर सेल्फ फ्रॉम कोरोना वायरस डिजीज ड्यूरिंग दिस टफ टाइम ऑफ वर्ल्ड वाइड पैंडेमिक. दिस एजुकेशनल वीडियो इज फॉर एवरीबडी इन जनरल but specifically for the patients who have some underlying disease or who are suffering from liver disease or are post liver transplant patients. Let me start by sharing some basic information about coronavirus with you. Coronavirus is a type of flu virus, as we all know, but it is very different from other flu viruses. We know that the mortality of coronavirus disease, that is risk of dying, is much higher as compared to other flu viruses. If we compare it to the influenza virus, where the mortality is around 0.1%, that is 1 in 1,000, the mortality of coronavirus disease is around 2 to 3%, that is 20 to 30 in 1,000, which is very high as compared to other influenza viruses. The second way it is very different from other viruses is that it is highly infected. It gets spread from one person to another person with a great ease, and infectivity in the society is very, very high. Now let's understand who are at risk of death or who are at the risk of dying if they get coronavirus disease. The data suggests us that the people who are more than 40 to 50 years of age, people who have some underlying comorbidities like hypertension, diabetes, cardiac disease or cancers, or people who have decreased immunity because of transplantation, like post-transplant patients or end-stage kidney or liver disease patients. These type of patients are more likely to get severe coronavirus disease and are more likely to die as compared to a younger population. That's why it becomes much more relevant for this subgroup of population to protect themselves from this coronavirus during this epidemic or a pandemic. Now let's understand how this virus spreads from one person to another, as this will help us understanding the measures we need to take to protect ourselves. The virus primarily spreads from one person to another person by three ways. Number one, by directly inhaling the droplets from the infected person. Number two, by directly touching the infected person by shaking hands or by hugging them. And number three, by indirectly touching the surfaces on which virus might have landed, and you inadvertently touch those surfaces, and then you touch your mucous membranes like eyes, mouth or nose, and that becomes the entry point of the virus into your respiratory tract. Now, what are the droplets? We talk about droplets very often, but we must understand what are the droplets and how they are the primary route of spread of coronavirus from one person to another person. Now the droplets are small balls of saliva, and if an infected person shoots them from their mouth, these small droplets contain a significant dose of virus to infect anybody else. Now these droplets are usually more than 10 micrometers in size. And depending on the type of activity that person performs, these droplets fall to the ground with the help of gravity at various distances. For example, if we are just normally talking, these droplets will fall within 1 meter of the body. But if we are coughing or sneezing, these droplets have potential to go up to 4 to 6 meters from the mouth of the infected person. Now these droplets finally, due to the gravity, land on either ground or various surfaces. Now, depending on the type of surface, these droplets and the virus can remain alive in these droplets for various periods of time. It is estimated that they can remain alive on steel or plastic for about 4 to 6 days time. And if we inadvertently touch those surfaces, we can actually infect ourselves. So this much basic understanding is required to protect ourselves from the coronavirus disease. Now, what are the measures we need to take to protect ourselves and our loved ones from this coronavirus disease? I'm going to elaborate on five measures which we need to take to protect ourselves as well as the community as well as our loved ones from this disease. The first and the most important measure we need to take is social distancing. What is social distancing? Social distancing means that we maintain a significant distance from another person, whether infected or not infected, so that his or our droplets doesn't infect that person. Now the question is, how much distance is a safe distance? So now, depending on scenario, WHO has recommended 1 to 2 meters distance as the safe distance to not get infected from the droplets. But in my opinion, because the latest studies and data suggest that droplets can travel up to 4 to 6 meters when person is coughing or sneezing, we should maintain at least 4 to 6 meters of distance from another person. Now, sometimes it's difficult to maintain distance from another person, but you should stick to the basic rule that as much distance as possible would help protecting you and your loved ones from this disease. Now, the second thing I want to bring to your notice is wearing the masks. There is a common question that people are asking, that should we wear masks and go out? Although WHO data suggests that wearing masks is only recommended for an infected person or healthcare workers. But in my opinion, everybody should wear masks and then step out of the house, especially the post-transplant patients and patients who are suffering from chronic diseases. Why so? Because as I already told you that droplet infections or droplets are the primary source of infection. But what kind of mask we should wear? Now people are hoarding N95 masks. So it is my humble request to everybody that N95 masks are only for healthcare workers, which come in very close contact with the patients. Please, please, please don't hoard these masks and don't take their right away to protect themselves. You can wear any kind of mask, a surgical mask or a mask made out of a double cloth. You can make it in your house, you can wash it. And once you wear it and you go out, you will be protected from the droplet infections if you follow social distancing as a routine. The third thing I want to tell everybody is not to inadvertently touch unnecessary surfaces like doorknobs, like buttons of the elevator. You should keep a toothpick with yourself to press the buttons of the elevators, or you can keep a cloth or a tissue paper with you to open the door knobs. Fourth measure, which is very important, is frequently washing your hands. Now, there are a lot of people who are hoarding sanitizers. Sanitizers are not a good way to protect yourself. Once you use sanitizers, they don't go to every part of the hand. There are good videos available how to wash your hands. Even a simple soap solution used for washing hands will give you much more protection than sanitizers itself. So I'd recommend washing hands as frequently as possible, and every time you wash your hands, do it about 20 to 30 seconds. Fifth measure which I want to tell you is that please, please, please don't self-medicate yourself. After the president of US announced that hydroxychloroquine might be an effective medicine for coronavirus disease, people have started buying these medicines over the counter and hoarding these medicines. This is not at all right. Please understand that hydroxychloroquine at present, there is not sufficient or enough data to suggest that hydroxychloroquine is effective in such situations. And secondly, these are toxic medicines and they have severe side effects. More people are likely to die of the side effects than of the coronavirus disease if they regularly use these medicines. Now with this, I end this video by giving you two social messages. Number one, it's very important for us now, more than ever, to change our social behaviors and habits, not only for this pandemic, but for future epidemics too. Look at the countries like Hong Kong, Korea, and Japan, where people routinely follow these social habits. The rate of infection in those countries are much lower as compared to India or any other developed world. Second message I want to give is mainly for the youngsters. I know that youngsters are believing that they have a greater immunity and they are immune to coronavirus infection. Please don't take this message home. This is not right. We are getting reports from the various countries that even younger people are getting infected with a severe disease. Although the percentage of people, younger people infected, getting infected from these diseases is much lesser. The more important fact is that younger population, if they get infected, are either asymptomatic carriers or are affected with the very mild symptoms. That's why all these younger population becomes the reservoir for spread of the infection to the community. So it is their moral, social responsibility to prevent the spread of infections and save the elder people of the society. So it is my humble request to all the youngsters to follow all the restrictions to combat this pandemic of coronavirus disease. I hope you'll find this video very helpful in protecting yourself as well as your family members and loved ones from coronavirus disease. Thank you so much.